All right, community, I have Chris with me, who is a community member who, despite knowing me, has managed to already lose around $3,000, I think about $3,200 roughly when we looked through and calculated. And that's because he's been sitting on a pile of PLS and decided not to use LL. We've talked about it a few times. It's just getting used to kind of clicking some of these things in DeFi. So he's been gracious enough to come on. I'm actually going to go through the whole process with him, open a vault. We're going to hit the stability pool. We're going to stake some loan and get a chance to show him the wonderful world of DeFi and liquid loans. So, Chris, thanks, brother. Welcome to the stage.
Yeah, look, thanks so much, WaLLrus. I really appreciate your time and your energy and efforts. I've been watching your content for a long time. And as you were saying, I've been watching and aware of the opportunity, but for whatever reason, just haven't pulled the trigger. And I think it's just because I've had a lot going on. I have my own business. And so I look at this and go, wow, this all sounds great. I go to do it. And then something else will come up. And then I just, you know, leave it be. So, mate, I just really appreciate the time and effort to help walk me through this for the very first time.
Absolutely, man. And that's what we hear with so many people, right? It's, hey, I'm savvy. I did this. I did that. I've done some of the right things. And I just haven't had the time and expertise to actually kind of go through and use DeFi to its fullest. So, I think it's a wonderful example. I'm sure there's probably a lot more Chris's in the ecosystem than there are WaLLrus's. And, you know, that's the responsibility that guys like myself and a lot of these other savvy members have in the ecosystem. We want to help things grow. We got to help onboard and make things simple and easy. So yeah, it's a pleasure, man. And I appreciate you coming through and, let's get you hooked up, man. You want to go ahead and open that bad boy? Let's go.
Absolutely. Absolutely. All right. Let me just get this open. Okie dokie. All right.
Now for everyone following along with us, again, I've talked to Chris a little bit. We've kind of connected a wallet. We've clicked a few buttons here and there, but we want to make sure that we kind of start from the very beginning here. So now again, we're going to open a vault for the first time. All this kind of really cool stuff, but just a quick walkthrough of kind of the overview of the Dapp itself. So right when you open up, you can see all the tokens at the top, their prices. You can see the TCR in the top left, which is that where you see that battery. And the TCR is the total collateral ratio. So we're going to dig into the collateral ratios a little heavier when we actually go to open the vault. But that's the amount collateralized versus the amount of USDL, the stable coin that's been minted for the entire platform. So you're going to see that ICR, which is individual collateral ratio. And that's going to be whatever the percentages that we open up for Chris. And then we're going to get into debt in front as well. So debt in front is the amount of USDL that's minted at a more aggressive ICR than what Chris has. And that's going to be important for redemptions and a few things that we're going to touch on. But all that data is right there across the top. It's really clean and easy to see. Now, if you don't have a WaLLrus or when you get a chance to go through and watch this and you want to go through and get a refresher, these six videos right here are awesome. So we're actually going to go ahead and watch these really fast, and I recommend that you do as well. Obviously, those videos are super, super helpful. And there's one other thing that I would recommend. Now, we're going to touch most of the points here in the video, but again, when you go through this for yourself, I recommend that you check these videos out. And then if you want to go down and click product tour down there at the bottom left.
Bottom left. There we go.
So this is super cool. So if anyone who's got any games downloaded on their phone, all that kind of cool stuff, you're used to kind of having that tour. I always kind of say it's like when you open up an RPG game and they tell you to go fight these guys and collect this reward. Similar to that, we have the product tour, and it's going to walk you through all of the buttons, give you some explainers, talk about what the stats mean, all this kind of really cool stuff. That's just, again, a nice walkthrough as a reminder for everything here. So I'd recommend that you walk through all 27 points of the product tour. We're going to dive into them right now as far as working through and getting Chris's vault open. But it's another really, really great tool to make this stuff super easy.
Yeah, this is actually really cool. Really, really cool.
Yeah, it's sometimes I forget that we've built in so many things like the analytics page and all this stuff here. You know, we touch it all the time that I forget, you know, again, especially depending on what dApps you're used to, or again, like someone like yourself who's kind of a believer in DeFi, but hasn't got the chance to interact with it too much. I forget how much stuff we built in that's really intuitive. So really excited to see that. So now is the time, brother. You ready to go ahead and crack open a vault?
Absolutely. Let's do it. Let's get it done.
All right. Okay. So the first thing we're going to do is connect your wallet.
Up here. Yep. Okay.
Now, obviously, guys, we're going to go ahead and blur out his address and all that stuff, make sure that Chris isn't doxxed. But just as a reminder, because, again, we're so security focused. Again, take your time. Be very, very careful with your seeds. No one needs them. I'm not going to message you in Telegram. It's not me DMing you. There's no LL customer service. The only one who needs those seeds is you and God. That's it, period. Be very, very careful with them. And always take the time to make sure that you're going to the proper site, that you're verifying contract addresses, all these kinds of things. It's really important. Okay, so now we've got Chris connected here. So we actually went through and did this just a minute ago because we were going through and loading his tokens, but I'm going to go ahead and show you guys anyway. So Chris, if you want to go ahead and click the loan logo at the top there. So you can see that it says already added to the wallet. So if you want to go and clear the cache, go ahead and let's add it again just so they can see it real quick. So this is so that you don't have to go anywhere and ask for the token addresses. This is how you can get your USDL and your loan added directly right into your wallet, your MetaMask, whatever is easy. And then also there is the add tokens button down at the bottom left, and it will give you the address there to copy in case you're going to search them on another side or you're looking at, say, a liquidity pool, things like that. They're available. But again, you can just click the logos, really simple and easy. Okay, loans added. Obviously, it'd be the same for USDL. Very, very simple.
Yeah, 100%. Like, I wouldn't even know what to do to bring those across to my wallet.
Right. But again, that's what it means for all of us. And those of us that are building stuff in the ecosystem, this is what it takes. Like, you got to be very diligent, make this stuff easy. It's got to be easy for people to use. Okay, first tab, borrow USDL. And this is where we're actually opening the vault. So this is where we're going to deposit PLS. We're going to mint USDL. This is the heart of the whole ecosystem right here. So now you can see in this, when you go to the deposit PLS line there, this is how much pulse we're going to lock up in the vault. And it's going to actually auto populate those stats on the side. So we're going to go ahead and put in basically the entire amount, 194 million. Okay. All right. So what this populates here is it defaults at 150. Now, depending on the state of the protocol, depending on what you're looking at as a user, all of these things, you probably would like to go higher than that. Now, there's going to be some people who are more aggressive that would like to go lower, but we want to be much, much safer. So again, I know you run a business. I know that you're newer to DeFi. I know that you don't want to touch these things, right?
I want to be very conservative. I'll probably look at this maybe once a week, if that. So right. I definitely want to be on the safer side, please.
So all of those things say higher. Like, they say more safe. They say less capital efficient. They say go up there and make this really simple. So if you're similar to Chris and you don't want to check this all the time, if you're not wanting to push and pull and maximize all these things, if you're just wanting to make a safe yield and come in and click a button or two once a week, then you're going to want to default to a lot of things that Chris is doing. Now, of course, myself, other players, we're going to do more aggressive things. That's not what this one's about, but just know that those things are an option. You can look that stuff up and, you know, come chat with us in the Telegram. So let's go ahead and let's lower that borrow amount down to about, let's do 3,700 and see where that gets us. Okay. So this shows us a couple of things here. So if you look on the side, it's going to show us what we're depositing, which is the amount. It's going to show us what the current borrowing fee is, which is only 1.27%, and there's 0% interest. So there's no interest and there's no repayment schedule. So you can keep this position open as long as you want and collect the yield. You can close it at any time. And other than that, in this case, that $47 there that is going to be collected as that fee, which will get paid out to all the loan holders, which you're going to be very, very shortly. So that's the only cost associated with it. So that liquidation reserve you'll see there, that 200 is only there in the event of a liquidation. So in case that collateral gets down below 110%, then that 200 basically just sits static. And when you close your vault, that 200 will be repaid. So you're going to see that our borrow amount plus that fee and the liquidation reserve is what that total debt is. Does that make sense there?
It absolutely doesn't. And this is what blows my mind. So you're saying there's zero interest and zero repayments. So I could take that 3,700 and what could I do with that? Like that USDL, what could I do with that?
So what we're going to do is we're going to put it in the stability pool, which we'll explain a little bit what it is, but that's where you're going to get a very kind of low hanging fruit when it comes to the yield side. But you can literally do anything. So you could buy more PLS and you could sort of maximize your exposure, like a light form of leverage. You could hop into another project that you think is going to do especially well. So for example, let's say something was launching that you really wanted to be early on, or there's a big dip on another token. You could take that 3,700, buy into that other project. And then as you either want to DCA or however you plan on normally bringing funds in, you could come in and pay that off, or you could leave it open like this and just modulate between the positions. You can literally, or you could take it through and swap it to say USDC, USDT, Coast. You could off ramp it and go spend that money in the real world. You can literally do anything you want with it.
So you go buy a coffee.
Sure can.
Or buy put a deposit down, or buy a TV or something with that. That's awesome.
That's it. Yep. It's the USDL itself. It's just a means of exchange between these other things, and you can swap it into again Coast or go out through any of the kind of standard exchanges or an OTC desk. However, if you get funds in and out, you could take that USDL and basically swap to whatever mechanism allows you to do that and cash it out in the real world if you want.
See, that still just blows my mind. Again, like, I just don't understand how it works in terms of, look, no interest and no repayments, but I'm happy that that's the case.
that's why there's that minimum on liquidations, and that's kind of the magic of DeFi, is that there's no one in between you and the code, so there's no one to pay. That's a huge part of the magic, is that these transactions get ran by the blockchain. It's a beautiful ecosystem that allows us to do things that just wouldn't be viable or even possible in sort of the traditional markets.
Yeah, that's incredible. Now,
so our ICR, the way we have this set up, and again, the ICR is your collateral ratio. The TCR is the whole ecosystem. So we want to make sure that our ICR is way away from liquidations, which are at 110 or in some cases 150. It just doesn't happen very often. You want to make sure that if you really want to be hands-off and you're someone like Chris, I want to touch this thing once a week, you want to make sure the ICR is above the kind of TCR in the platform. So right now it's at 808. We've had a bunch of pumps. There's been redemptions. People are really conservative. All kinds of things have gone into that TCR being really high right now. In the future, it could be less than that. So say the overall ecosystem was being more aggressive and we were at like 400, we could probably get up around that, again, 425, 450. And depending on how aggressive it was, we'd still want to have some space in case of liquidations. But for the way it's set up right now, the 850, give or take a tenth of a percent, makes us very safe. So this means that there's essentially zero risk. You'd see that the liquidation price would have to be lower than the all-time low that PLS ever was, down at four zeros and a two. We're going to be above the majority of other users. So we have very low risk on redemptions, which have been trending down in the first place. You know, again, there's been some spikes here and there. So this is a super safe. This is no interest, hands off, come in and click some claims occasionally. So we are now about to mint. You're going to literally create this $3,700 worth of stablecoin as soon as you click confirm. So go ahead and pull the trigger, buddy.
All right, let's do this. I'm excited.
Yep. Now, if you do this outside of DeFi, it's counterfeiting. It's very important. You can't be printing dollars in the regular world, but here it makes perfect sense, and USDL is awesome. All right, transaction confirmed. You have just opened your first vault and minted USDL, and all the loan holders who are staked just got paid out $47. So the whole world's happy.
Yeah, that's great. Right. How do I get a piece of that $47?
We're going to get there. We're going to get there. That'll be one of our next steps. So now, again, now we have this 3,700 minted. This is in our wallet. We can do what, again, we at this point, we could take this as like a traditional loan. We could off ramp, go spend it somewhere in the real world. But the whole point for this here, again, is we want a yield, right? So now we're going to go through and we're actually going to go through and put this in the stability pool. And we're going to talk a little bit about how that function works. So go ahead and click that next tab there at stability pool. Okay. So now you see that big, juicy 154% APR. So absolutely, we want a piece of that.
What does that mean though? Sorry. So for a someone like me who has no idea, what does the APR actually mean?
So that's annual percentage return. So again, it's always going to be an average over what we've seen up to this point. But as of right now, and it just moved, is probably another staker came and added some value there. what you're going to see is that's going to be that percentage return. So we're going to put $3,700. And if the system sort of stayed in the state it is in now, you would end up at the end of the year collecting around $5,300.
That's amazing. That's amazing.
And again, there'll be, even as that number varies, again, that annual percentage return, we're going to be able to compound along, and we're going to show you how all that functions here in a minute. Like, you're actually going to have rewards before we hang up the call here in a minute. So we're going to go ahead and stake this USDL. So go ahead and click 100%. So we're going to stake it all and then hit confirm. And while you're confirming that transaction, I'm going to explain the stability pool. So the stability pool gets yield from two places. One, it gets what's called an emission, which means that every block on the chain gets paid out loan. So everyone, there's $19 million that's staked in the stability pool. That's all going to be getting paid out a loan token reward. So again, the loan token holders are the ones who got that $47. We're going to get some of that here shortly. But as that stake comes, you're going to get all these loan emissions. The other thing it's going to do is going to give you a premium on liquidations. So whenever a vault is liquidated, there's a few things that get paid to the liquidator, whoever actually clicks the button, or usually is a script. But whoever runs that function gets that $200 premium and a few things. But as a stability pool provider, what it's going to do is basically take the margin on that liquidation event, which is about 9 to 10%. And you're going to collect that premium in PLS. So essentially, that $3,700 in USDL will get burned and basically turned into, for every dollar, about $1.09 worth of PLS. So you pick up that margin every time that happens.
That's awesome.
And so when it does this, it's going to show up there on the right-hand side. So in your stability pool, it's going to sit there and show you, if you're adding, it's going to show you what your totals are. But in this case, as a new stake, it's going to show that $3,700 as your stake. It's going to show what your percentage of the entire pool is, like what your percentage of those fees will be. And then below that, you're going to see your rewards. And it's going to show you, again, that liquidation gain for PLS and then the loan rewards for the emissions. So now, right now, your yield machine is turned on. All you're going to do, if you only do this here, you're basically come in, double check your ICR. And while we're looking at that now, so this is your home base here. So if you go and look at your ICR, if this is the following week, your ICR is, 40-ish% north of the TCR. Nice, super safe, hands off, no problems. But now we can see that debt in front metric. So right now, there's 17,203,101 USDL that's debt in front. And that's the amount of USDL that would be there in case of a redemption event. And now you don't have to worry about those either. So now you're on the super safe side and we're just collecting yield. And all we basically need to do is come in here and claim rewards. That's it. You'll hit claim. You'll collect your PLS. You can add that PLS to your vault. You can take the loan and then go and stake it. And this is it. Like, as far as your kind of central point here, we're going to go over the staking pool for loan, but this is it. You're rocking. You're generating yield right now as we talk.
That sounds great. And so with that, you're saying the debt in front, the 17 million in front of me, is there a good number to aim for there for someone like me? Or is it just basically, as long as my ICR is higher than TCR, I should be okay?
So it's a bit of an imperfect barometer, but it helps quite a bit. And just being that you want a bunch, right? Okay. Now, again, the number depends on how often you're checking, how aggressive you are. Do you know how, in the event of redemptions, are you, willing to go back and rebuy the PLS? Are you willing to be aggressive and take the premium? So there's a few different caveats depending on the user. But for the most part, we would want to see, again, for a hands-off user, probably double-digit millions. And again, that TCR or your ICR being north of the ICR.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, sounds good.
So now we can see here. So we'll have, again, this is sort of your home base as you come in and check for rewards. You'll see the TVL, you'll see the TCR, all the protocol metrics at the bottom. You'll double check your vault metrics and everything at the top. Go ahead and click refresh.
Okay.
Hey. All right. And you've been paid.
Yeah, that looks good.
Yep. So you've already got a loan token reward there. So again, these will sit here and pile up. Now this is a relatively small amount. Again, you've been there 30 seconds. But again, like, this is all we're doing. So we're going to go through. So now, again, it'll claim both at one time. So go ahead and click claim your rewards.
See, this is the thing, like, this is what I love, is like, literally, I've just been sitting here doing nothing, and that's come in for doing nothing.
For coming in, supporting the system, locking up TVL, adding the stability pool, you get to click your rewards here.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And so when this goes through here, we're actually go to that next tab and go to the staking pool. You want to go and click staking pool?
Absolutely.
All right. So now we're on the staking pool. So this is where you're going to stake the loan. So this is that part of that compounding I spoke about just a minute ago, right before we hopped on the camera here. So now we're going to get a chance to compound. So when you got that reward and loan, that loan is also going to give you a yield. So the yield in loan right now is massive, 75%. Now, the way loan gets paid its reward is it gets a redemption fees. So every time anyone redeems, there's a small fee associated with that. And that's going to pay you out PLS, which again, you can take, keep, use for transactions, add your vault. And then there's also what's the issuance gain. So the issuance is when someone else opens a vault or mints more USDL. So that $47 that you minted would be an issuance gain. So if you'd had loan staked previous to this, though, all those holders got a small piece of that $47. So we're going to go ahead and stake your loan right now and get you added in this pool as well. So let's go ahead and hit confirm. And now on the side, it's going to show you your loan amount, the amount of loan that you've staked. It's going to show, as you add, it'll show you your previous and updated stake size, that balance. And then it's going to give you your pool share as well. So it's going to show you as you're adding to that pool. And then you're going to come through. Now, what's interesting about the yield in loan is, again, it only happens when there's redemptions and when people mint. So you could have days it could be theoretically zero. Now, it doesn't happen very often. There's always so much activity. But you could have a day that's zero, and the very next day it could be 300%. It could be a huge, huge return. So you're going to get a lot of these spikes and waves that come with all this activity. But that's true yield, right? So that's what's really kind of beautiful about the way these things work is it's almost like a revenue share. When LL does a lot of business, which again, is not LL the team, it's LL the protocol, which means that all those things, they are owned by the community. So now you have a piece of that. So the more people that are on LL using the ecosystem, the more that revenue is going to pay out. So those literally come from other users and people using the protocol, man. And now you're a part of that.
And so, like, for me, like, should I just keep on going through and adding more loan token, like, to the staking pool here, and then what do I add into the stability pool? That's USDL. So, yes, should I just keep on, claiming these ones, the loan tokens here, and then just putting them back in the staking pool here?
Yep. So as you go through, you can balance a few things here. So you can always just cash out the loan, but I'm assuming, knowing you, that you're long-term thinker, that you're basically just like, hey, I'm here to take the yield, especially when they're that juicy. You'll just keep claiming all your loan, coming and staking it here. And see, you actually picked up. So someone did a small redemption while we're talking. So it's four zeros and a three, but you've got a small piece of PLS already. So what you can do with either the gains from liquidations or redemptions, you can add those to your vault. Again, you could just sell those directly as yield. But what most people will do is, they're going to take the PLS they get from redemptions, add that to their vault. They're going to take the loan, stake it here. The same thing. They're going to take the PLS they gain from the loan pool, add it back to their vault. And then they're going to take that USDL, that issuance gain. And you can do two things there. You can either take it directly and just add it back to the stability pool and keep that loop going of compounding. Or you can take that and start paying down your debt there as well. So you can do that to lower your USDL that you have minted, that debt there, that collateral position. So you can lower that, say raise your ICR. You can just pay it down so that your PLS is unencumbered. Or again, as you are here where you're super safe and you just want the yield, you can just stake it back in the stability pool.
So for me, like, so all these things you're talking about here, would it be okay if we do like another call in another week or two, maybe another week or so, I guess, just so we can go over that too? Because I would love to, again, if it's okay, have you walk me through exactly those things, because when I do it, I know it'll lock in my brain a lot quicker and a lot better, I guess. And is that okay?
100%. I'm sure everyone else would be excited to hear the walkthrough as well. And I appreciate you hopping on. But again, you saw it here. There's no magic, no arithmetic, no trigonometry. It's relatively simple once you just kind of get a feel for clicking the button. So what you just did over the 20 minutes or so we've been on the call is, open up a collateral position. You minted $3,700 worth of USDL. Now you have that collecting, 150% APR in the stability pool, and then you staked your loan reward already gaining 75, and now you could just sit here and compound. So yeah, we'll touch base in a week or so. We can kind of do like an update and see where everything's at, see how your stack's already growing. But that's awesome. Brother. You're on the team, an open vault. You're collecting yield. You're minting, USDL. Man, this is DeFi.
Yeah, I love this. And obviously, I've got my camera off because I want to remain anonymous, but I'm smiling from ear to ear. Again, I know these are very, very, very small numbers here, but just the fact that I've got things coming in for literally doing nothing. And then I was just thinking, I couldn't help but think that, where I'm based, banks, they'll charge you like monthly fees. And I'm assuming there's no monthly fees for this at all. So like no bank is going to actually give you money like this without taking money away in fees. And I just love just the fact I'm sitting here just having this conversation and learning, actually. And again, while I'm sitting here learning, this is all coming in. And I know it's small, but I know it's going to add up over time because I'm definitely not in this for the short term.
Absolutely, my man. So, man, this is a lot of fun. Thanks for hopping on. I'm glad you got to see the rewards already coming in, as we said here, and we're on the call. We'll touch base in a week. For everyone there sitting at home, hopefully you guys got a chance to look through, see that it's not that scary. It's very simple. Again, check out the videos, the product tour, look at the blog, the start here. We have so much resources. We'll put that stuff down in the description. Our team has got content everywhere. And again, Chris is not a big DeFi guy, but he's savvy. He's got a bag of PLS. He runs a business, smart guy. It just takes someone to kind of come in here and walk this through. So hopefully this was very helpful for you guys. And Chris, thanks again, brother. We'll hop on another call. I'm sure everyone will enjoy it, man. And you're in the money.
Mate, thank you so much for your time, WaLLrus. I know it's very, very precious, and I really appreciate you walking me through. Thank you so much.
Cheers, brother. Appreciate it. Y'all stay safe at home.